Love abounds in all things, excels from the depths to beyond the stars, and is lovingly disposed to all things. Welcome, my beautiful brothers and sisters, connecting from all over Mother Earth on this great Kaza Day. The current is now running to the portal of the Casa de Dominacio, the house of love, where the medicine is love, here in Abidjania, in the heart of Brazil. And it's another beautiful day. It's a new moon, so time for new beginnings. Painful endings are bright new beginnings, as we let go of anything and everything that no longer serves us. We have deep blue skies as we remember the shawl, the mantle of our Divine Mother Mary, her protection and love. And of course, it's Kaza Blue and the sky unites us and the clouds are back, lots of them. So we have shade on a hot day, which is great. And of course, they're passing by slowly and surely, reminding us that all things are impermanent and we are just travelers here on earth, and this too will pass. And we have butterflies everywhere also, as we remember our transformation, that we're shifting dimensions, and this can be quite difficult, but let's stay elevated. And you may be able to hear the birds serenading us. In the Kaza this morning, we had a few little bright green birds flying around and playing in the current room when the current is on, which, no coincidences, no accidents. Today also, as well as our beautiful Saint Hildegard, we are celebrating the feast of the stigmata of our brother Saint Francis of Assisi. So all of creation is rejoicing, and we are connecting with this magnificent high vibration. So there's a lot going on as we settle deeper and deeper into this divine work. Wherever you are in the world, if you're lying down under a crystal bed or just lying down, relax. This is great. If you prefer to sit upright with our heads elevated, so this energy can flow fluidly, freely and easily through each and every one of us, connecting us across the miles, this beautiful current of love and light. If you remember to put a glass of water beside you, this will be blessed, and we will drink it at the end of the work to nourish us, mind, body and spirit. And as we close our physical eyes, we open our spiritual eyes, where we can see everything beyond appearances. All there is. We are reminded again and again that we're spiritual beings having a human experience, and not the other way around. We're not the body. We're so much more. The body merely houses our eternal spirits. And we have so much help available to us from beyond the veil. So let's take courage and strength today from our beautiful sister, Saint Hildegard of Bingen. She was one of the most gifted spiritual teachers of all time. She was known as the patron saint of creativity. So it goes well with our brother, Saint Francis of Assisi, who also embraced Mother Earth. She was a remarkable woman, a first in many fields and a doctor of the church. She was a Benedictine abbess and founder of a community, a writer, a playwright, poet, artist, composer, musician, herbalist and pharmacist who lived in the 12th century in Germany. Amazing. As a mystic, Hildegard was a visionary in all senses of the word. She was a very sensitive recipient of numerous prophetic, God-sent mystical visions with deep insights during her life, and is said to have been a miracle worker. She has a very unusual life. She was given to the church at age 8 and took vows at 15 in a Benedictine monastery. She was sickly most of her life and she still made it to 81 years of age. So there's hope for us yet. Hildegard said that she had visions of God her whole life. The first shade of the living light, as she called them, came at age 3, starting very early, and the visitations never stopped. She described one as heaven was opened and a fiery light of exceeding brilliance came and permeated my whole brain and inflamed my whole heart and my whole breast. Not like a burning, but like a warming flame. The God light. At age 43, when she became abbess, she said God told her to write down what you see and hear, and for the first time revealed to her the visions of the world. She was a prolific letter writer who corresponded with the most important political and religious figures of her time. Just like Dom Ignacio and Padre Pio, they wrote so many spiritual lessons, and we have so much to learn from these amazing entities. Hildegard was a famous botanist as well. She studied the natural sciences and used herbs, tinctures, and precious stones as healing medicines. Back in the 12th century, she invented holistic medicine. Her mysticism promotes a oneness with nature, just like St. Francis of Assisi. And as one might find in observing plant life, Hildegard believed the unifying power of the divine shows itself in the form of growths. She closely observed the documented human ailments and remedies. Her belief in interconnectivity underscores our balance with nature. How beautiful. Calling it the cosmic womb of the divine feminine. She wrote 2 treatises on medicine and natural history. Her written works, which focus on history, medicine, and cosmology, a theory about the natural order of the universe. She wrote 9 books, 70 poems, 72 songs, and a play. Her books are in print and her music is widely performed today. We'll play some of it. Music for her represented the balance of body and soul. She saw music as the interconnectivity between humanity and the universe. Hildegard once said that she wanted her music to be as close to sitting on the breath of God as she could get. We're certainly in a very high vibration today. And although she led a monastic life, Hildegard travelled widely and was very, very influential during her lifetime and continues to inspire us to this very day. So we are working with this magnificent high vibration of love and light through the power of our sister, Saint Hildegard of Bingen. So with this joy and celebration in our hearts, let's turn to our brother Jesus, who gave us a beautiful gift of the Lord's Prayer many years ago. And this teaches us how to pray, how to talk to God, how to forgive each other and particularly ourselves, starting there, and how to surrender to the will of the divine power, and how to embrace all of these gifts of creation that we have received. So let us pray with open hearts, joyfully, trustingly, without ceasing. The Lord's Prayer from its original Aramaic, the language of Jesus and Mary. O birther, father, mother of the cosmos, you create all that moves in light. Focus your light within me and make it useful. As rays of a beacon, show the way. Create your reign of unity now. Through my fiery heart and willing hands, your one desire then acts with mine. As in all light, so in all forms. Grant what I need each day in bread and insight, subsistence for the call of growing life. Loosen the cords of errors binding me, as I release the stranglehold of others' guilt. Don't let surface things delude me, rather liberate me from what holds me back from my true purpose. From you was born all ruling will, the power and the life to be, the song that beautifies everything as it renews from age to age. Truly, power to these words. May they be the source for which all of my actions grow, sealed in trust and in faith. Amen. And to our Divine Mother Mary, the Mother's Heart, the feminine power, Mother Earth, Queen of Peace. Hildegard taught that the Blessed Virgin Mary was the mother of medicine. How beautiful is that? We ask our Divine Mother in this very moment to intercede for us, her children, to somehow alleviate the suffering of humanity in these difficult days on earth, and to help us to go within on the journey of the heart, and to find the peace, the harmony, the compassion, the gratitude, the love, the forgiveness, the humility, the joy, the abundance deep, deep within us. And it is within all of us. We are divine beings, all children of the divine consciousness, helping us all incarnate and disincarnate on our healing journey back home into the celestial fields. One light, one love, one soul, one family. Our Mother, who is the void that creates all matter, let we be one. Let we be one. Let we be one. Nourish us every moment through the power of now. Help us elevate our often wounded and fearful hearts to the purity of love and compassion. Shield us always, enfolding us in your starry night sky. And deliver us from judgment and separation. Amen.
Thank you.
we bask in the beautiful high vibration of Saint Hildegard's many, many composed music chants. We are learning a lot about these many great elevated beings that went before us. And both Saint Hildegard and Saint Francis of Assisi were powerhouses for embracing all of creation as being interconnected with all of us, all creatures, working together in harmony, the divine consciousness. And we have a lot to learn going way back. We're talking about the 12th century, but they're always available to us here and now. And their teachings resonate with us so much, particularly now in this day and age. And gratitude always comes through with these great saints. And praise of the God of creation for giving us these gifts of life. And Saint Francis was the first to call Earth Mother. And in Saint Hildegard's words about praising the God of creation, reminding us that everything is interconnected in praise of our God. She says, the fire has its flame and praises God. The wind blows the flame and praises God. In the voice, we hear the word which praises God. And the word, when heard, praises God. So all of creation is a song of praise to God. And let us be reminded by Saint Francis today of his canticle of the creatures, calling all of creation our brothers and sisters. Let us pray. Most High, all-powerful, good Lord, all praise is yours, all glory, all honour and all blessing. To you alone, Most High, do they belong. No mortal lips are worthy to pronounce your name. All praise be yours, my Lord, to all you have made. And first, my Lord, brother, son, who brings the day, and through whom you give us light. How beautiful is he, how radiant in all his splendor. Of you, Most High, he bears the likeness. All praise be yours, my Lord, through sister moon and the stars in the heavens you have made them, bright and precious and fair. All praise be yours, my Lord, through brothers wind and air, and fair and stormy, all the weather's moods, by which you cherish all that you have made. And all praise be yours, my Lord, through sister water, so useful, humble, precious, and pure. All praise be yours, my Lord, through brother fire, to whom you brighten up the night. How beautiful is he, how cheerful, full of power and strength. All praise be yours, my Lord, to our sister, Mother Earth, who sustains us and governs us and produces various fruits with coloured flowers and herbs. All praise be yours, my Lord, to who grants pardon for love of you, to those who endure sickness and trial. Happy are those who endure in peace. By you, Most High, they will be crowned. All praise be yours, my Lord, to Sister Death, from whose embrace no mortal can escape. Woe to those who die in mortal sin. Happy those she finds doing your will. The second death can do them no harm. Praise and bless my Lord, and give him thanks, and serve him with great humility. Amen. us in this moment now become conscious of our breathing. Slow, gentle, deep, deep breaths into the heart center, the center of our being. Let us breathe in the future and breathe out the past. Breathing in a state of surrender and grace, letting go more and more of anything and everything that no longer serves us. Letting go is growing up into the light, the core of our being. Breathing in more and more and more divine love light from the everlasting source of all light. Permitting this beautiful love light to penetrate our very being here now, mind, body, spirit, nourishing us, filling us up to overflowing, giving us everything we need and much, much more to do this cleansing, healing work so needed now on Mother Earth. Working with the very essence of our being. Remembering we are love, we are light. Ebbing, flowing fluidly, freely, peacefully in this ocean of love and light. And with each precious breath pouring forth from our open hearts, filling Mother Earth with the highly vibrational, strong, sure, pure, crystal clear, divine love light. Transmuting all denser energies. Bringing in this new, bright, gorgeous, high vibration on the planet. In this very sacred moment. And as we embrace this magnificent high vibration, we are reminded that Saint Hildegard had visions of light starting when she was 3 years old. So she realized very early on that we are light beings. And Saint Francis of Assisi, the wounds of the stigmata brought the light of the Christ consciousness deep, deep into his being. And he shone this light all over Mother Earth. And as we come back to the planet time and time again in different human bodies, we are reminded that Master Lord Kitumi is said to be the final incarnation of our brother, Saint Francis of Assisi, multiplying the love light on Earth. As we pray Lord Kitumi's light prayer. I am light, glowing light, radiating light, intensified light. God consumes my darkness, transmuting it into light. This day, I am a focus of the central sun. Flowing through me is a crystal river, a living fountain of light that can never be qualified by human thought and feeling. I am an outpost of the divine. Such darkness as has used me is swallowed up by the mighty river of light, which I am. I am I am light. I live in light. I am light's fullest dimension. I am light's purest intention. I am light, 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 flooding the world everywhere I move. Blessing, strengthening, and conveying the purpose of the kingdom of heaven. Amen. we bask in this beautiful high vibration of our sister Saint Hildegard and our brother Saint Francis of Assisi. They were very much on the same page many moons ago. Let us be open to receive now in this sacred moment, taking a nice long deep breath, relaxing as much as we possibly can back into our physical bodies, and being open to receive as we surrender all of our problems, our anxieties, our fears, our pain, our hurt, our rage, our anger, our grudges, our resentments, anything that is not from the light, handing everything over to our Creator, the architect of the cosmos, transmuting all denser energy into divine light as we become lighter, unburdened, more peace and harmony with all of creation, of which each and every one of us is an integral part of. We're all in this together, all children of God, part of all of the cosmos. In our mind's eye now, let's visualize a waterfall, like the waterfall here at the Casa de Dom Ignacio, or any place of sacred running water that you know, with all the gifts of Mother Nature. Big blue butterflies helping us with our transformation. Strong green oak trees purifying our oxygen. Birds of paradise serenading us in a divine symphony. Carpets of magnificent, colourful, fragrant flowers being kissed by hummingbirds, bumblebees, and even more butterflies. Brilliant sunshine and crystal clear waters embodying rainbows of light. Let's all go to this beautiful place together. Bring your family and friends with you, and bring those you need to forgive and those who need to forgive you. This is a time of true forgiveness, of surrendering anything and everything that no longer serves us, that's stopping us, holding us back from becoming the beautiful light beings that we truly are, our very essence. And in this moment, let's bring any of our brothers and sisters who are particularly struggling and suffering in these difficult days, and there are many, who are suicidal, depressed, feeling isolated, abandoned. Our brothers and sisters who are homeless, languishing in migrant camps, helping us to wake up to the fact that we are all children of God. And let's hold in our hearts all of our brothers and sisters on the West Coast of America who are really struggling now with these devastating fires. And here in the Amazon, the indigenous and the Pantanal, asking Saint Francis of Assisi to help to alleviate the suffering of all ecological disasters, hurricanes, earthquakes, drought, anywhere, everywhere on earth, that the forces of Mother Nature are so powerful. And let's bring our brother medium Joao into this high vibration. And anyone who has suffered or who is suffering on account of the problems at the Casa. And we never forget our brothers and sisters without their physical bodies who need to be liberated into the light, extending this magnificent high vibration to them also. Every being deserves to be healed, whether we have a body or not. And as we receive this magnificent high vibration from on high, pouring into our open hearts, let's share our bounty with the world, allowing it to gush forth into all hospitals, helping our angel doctors and nurses, healthcare professionals, patients, anyone who's in a caring capacity on Mother Earth in these challenging days. pouring into all nursing homes helping our elders, into asylums, hospices, prisons, orphanages, anywhere, everywhere on planet Earth where our brothers and sisters are suffering in pain or are hungry. The children of the world, they don't need to suffer, they're innocent. This God light gushing forth now into all war zones, anywhere there's conflict, fighting, disharmony, riots, bringing peace in our lifetime. Saint Rita is always with us. To God, all things are possible. This magnificent high vibration now penetrating the consciousness of our government leaders and anyone who's in a position of authority over another human being, helping them to wake up to our divine essence, to make good decisions about our future and the future of this planet so under pressure right now, not only for us, but for future generations to come, to put people before profit. We're all in this together. In this sacred moment now, this pristine, crystal clear energy gushing forth into all ecosystems, regenerating, renewing, recalibrating Mother Earth. Already she's bouncing back. Hallelujah. Praise God. Miracles abound. God is great. In this beautiful moment, this gorgeous high vibration enveloping Gaia, growing, expanding, multiplying, cleansing and healing all beings, carnage and disincarnate, as it pours forth into the universe. May all beings, with or without bodies, all creatures, great and small, be happy and be at peace and harmony and tranquility with this beautiful, ever-growing current of love and light. Amen. this beautiful moment now, as we absorb this magnificent high vibration of love and light through the music of Saint Hildegard. We are in total gratitude to God Almighty for another opportunity for us to come together as one family, this beautiful collective consciousness, to tune into the current of the Casa de Dominatio, to be able to become a little bit lighter, to know that we're all children of God, and that we're all in this together, brothers and sisters, in the light. We're just walking each other home. And thank you to God Almighty for sending all of your beautiful messengers of love, ascended masters. Lord Katumi is with us today. Angels, archangels, guardian angels, elevated beings, unseen forces, beautiful high vibration. And these magnificent entities of light and love always with us, 24/7. We just need to reach out and ask them to help us. And particularly today, we thank Saint Hildegard of Bingen, a phenomenal powerhouse of a woman who is teaching us how to surrender, how to hand everything over to God, knowing that everything will be all right, all is in divine order. To unburden ourselves. In her words, she says, "I reach out my hand to God that he may carry me along as a feather is borne weightlessly by the wind." And both Saint Hildegard and our brother, Saint Francis of Assisi, embraced all of creation. Their teachings are beautiful and very relevant to us now, to really work our way through this difficult time on earth. They are available to us 24/7. And St. Francis's feast day today of him bearing the stigmata reminds us that the wounds are where the light gets in. And his presence felt this morning in the casa with all of the birds serenading us and playing in the current room. There is no doubt they are with us every step of this journey, all the entities, all of God's messengers of love. So we are really loved by our Creator. And as always, our beautiful brother Jesus, Prince of Peace, and his and our Divine Mother Mary, Queen of Peace, their sacred hearts beaming out their love light to us here in this valley of tears, helping us in these challenging days to wake up to our divine essence, which is love and light, and knowing that when our earthly life is finished and we learn these hard lessons, that we will be liberated into their open arms in the celestial fields, where there's no more suffering and no more pain. How great is that? And to you, my great brothers and sisters, for your dedication, your courage, your commitment, your faith, your hope, your light, and your love, to be in service in all things for the greater glory of God. And for dedicating yourself time and time again for this work of the light As you allow your own light to shine, you automatically liberate others to do the same. As we learn to live by faith and not by sight, taking this giant leap of faith into the unknown, surrendering as much as we possibly can. We're only human after all. Don't give yourselves a hard time. We're doing the best we can. It's not always going to be perfect. Your faith is healing you and all of those around you, and Mother Earth. And your love and your light are changing the world forever for the better. Thank you. Let us pray. We ask that only the light of God shine through. That the light of Jesus and Mary dissolve all darkness. The light of the Christ consciousness dissolve all darkness. The fire of the Holy Spirit dissolves all darkness. The light of God is my strength, my power, my highest vibration, my transformative power. The presence of God's light within me is my strength. Amen. Love. Loving love. Namaste.